Hi, I'm Michael Smith. I'm 37 years old. I'm from Midland, Michigan, but I moved down to Cincinnati about 8 years ago. I followed my wife and her family down here. I've been married to Caitlin now for about 9 years, and then we have three boys. We have Gerwins, Jake, and Elijah, but we also have been doing foster care for about 6 years as well. So we've had a number of kids that have come in and out of our house. Most notably, we had a foster daughter that was with us for about 3 years. And over that time, my wife and I were able to make a great relationship with her father before she was reunited, so she still does come around our house, and we get to see her about once a month as well. In terms of work, I do auto financing. It's a little bit different than the typical auto financing as an underwriter, though. I get to actually sit down with customers, learn about their situations, go over their finances, and then we get to make a decision based on the outcome of that. Hobbies, I love running. I love mountain biking, both mountain and road biking. Did mountain biking, been doing that for probably about 15 years, now. I got to do a couple seasons of racing as well, which was a blast. Me and one of my buddies, it was kind of crazy. He just called me up one night. He's like, hey, you want to go to a race tomorrow? So I was like, sure, I'll give it a try. And then I got started doing that. Unfortunately, after having kids, I wasn't able to do that as often anymore. In terms of motorcycle license, I do have a motorcycle license. I used to have a motorcycle, don't have one right now though. Sold it a little bit ago, just haven't had a chance to get a new one yet. In terms of specific off-road motorcycle experience, I don't have any off-road experience on a motorcycle, just through mountain biking and trail riding. I have had opportunities to go to a lot of different places, do some pretty rough riding, the Potawatomi Trail up in Michigan, out in Brown County, Slatty Fork, West Virginia, did a little bit out in the Ohio Pile as well. Let's see here. Been to the Rockies, went to the Rockies probably about 15 or 16 years ago as well. Me and a couple of buddies, we piled in my mom and dad's minivan. I went out there and did a week of hiking in the backcountry. Absolutely amazing. I would love to go again and see the Rocky Mountains and actually see them in a new place. In terms of a spiritual life, I grew up in a Catholic home. Grew up getting baptized, First Communion, First Reconciliation, Confirmation. But then when I was in college, I kind of put God on the back burner, went ahead and did things my own way. And I did that for about 3 years before I found myself empty, found myself with lack of meaning, and just found myself in a position where I was like, what is missing in my life? And at that point in time, I recommitted my life to Christ. Since then, it's been probably about 14 or 15 years as well. I've been following God. That kind of talk ties into kind of what God is teaching me at this point in life, and that would be kind of running with endurance in the midst of everything. I think back to the parable of the sower, and there's some of the seed that falls down and it gets choked out by the thorns, and then he talks about the thorns being the worries of this world and the deceitfulness of wealth. So what does it look like after kind of the newness of faith is worn off? How do you continue when things sometimes you don't feel God as closely as you might, when you first started. Sometimes you just don't understand where he's going or where he's taking you, just the worries of life as well. So I would say that's kind of where God is teaching me right now. I would say in terms of my greatest, where I think that the greatest source of joy would definitely be the God has blessed me with a beautiful godly woman and three energetic boys. Greatest source of pain though would probably be just not where I thought I would be financially at this point in life. Why would I want to go on this trip? I'm athletic, I'm competitive. I love pushing myself to new limits. I love being on two wheels. I love being outdoors. I love camping. This is everything. And it just sparks an excitement in my heart about that, about the possibility. In terms of a campfire joke, it's not really a joke, but it's more of a pro tip that I'll leave you with. When you're out in the Rocky Mountains, there's going to definitely be bears out there. So we need to make sure that we are keeping safe with that. If we ever need to catch a bear, this is how you do that. Essentially, what you're going to do is you're going to dig yourself a deep hole. Then you got to fill that thing up with ashes, and you got to fill it up level with the ground so you can't even tell that there's anything there. And you got to go out and you put little peas all around it, and then you go ahead and hide behind a tree. At that point in time, when a bear comes up to take a pee, you're just going to run up there as fast as you can, and you kick him right in the ash hole.